Hey, welcome back to another episode of Wrath of the Righteous. And yeah, last time, it's a new day for me. But I distinctly remember getting my ass kicked by a particular creature in this room. Long story short, I looked the thing up because it was kind of bothering me. And I realized that, yeah. So, there's two ways to go about this. I could make this really easy for myself, or go full Vegeta and make it really hard for myself. I think for the few times and for all the buffs I've got running right now, I'm going to go hard mode and see how this works out, which means I'm not going to kill any of the additional cultists or attack the main summoner. I'm just going to let them finish their ritual and try to kill the summons. So, wish me luck, because I'm probably going to die a few times, and I will probably hate having to edit this video because of all the failures. Let's go. Yeah, gonna go for the achievement. Let them kill themselves. My AC is a 37 right now. Like I said, I'm buffed to the absolute hilt. Already have haste going, so I'm not going to worry about that. She was so slow anyway, like, there's not a whole lot she can do now at this point anyhow. I guess she could cast Greed Pit, but no, I'm gonna leave it as is. And this thing's got True Seeing, so invisibility doesn't work. That sucks. He rolled well.
Okay.
Well, shoot.
I shall survive this ordeal.
No, I don't think I will. Looking for a cast defensively. Oh, I forgot about Stigmata. Now I kind of want to load the game again. My 3 hit points. Damn it, it saved. Huh? 24 on a 48, or 23 on a 48, it's not bad. Got a lot of hit points, so. And he went down. Might not be able to do this, honestly. He just hits so hard.
You won't survive me.
I got an idea. This is an absolute Hail Mary. I did prepare a dismissal. Worth a try. All right. So let me activate my stigmata for more AC.
I need to concentrate.
I might have to see if I can find a ring of regeneration somewhere to counteract the stigmata. At my current level, it's like only one or two bleed damage, but adds up over time. Let's see what else was there. Oh my goodness, they're all practically going to sacrifice themselves first. Alright, hard mode it is. I wish I had higher DCs or something to pump it. You know, I do. Watch. I'm gonna make like shadow grease. Or a shadowy pit. Yeah, shadow grease right there. Oh well. AC is 34. It's actually going to be a little bit higher. Mine? So a stigmata going? It is not. Okay. Thank you. Oh, fuck. I didn't mean to skip. Ah. That's not good. Maybe Stigmata's broken. If that's the case, that might be a problem. Roll the 12. Oh my goodness.
You've crossed the wrong mark.
Pop most of his mirror images. She did like 70 damage to this thing's like 300 something. Jeez. Is mirror image gone? Looks that way. It's only good for one. You know, blinding would be good. Sealer there, right? Okay, yeah, should be fine. I couldn't overcome SR. Par for the course.
You won't survive me.
Alright, here this thing comes. Oh my gosh, she's alive.
They don't know how fragile they are.
Damn it. It's not going to do much. Desperate crit for 76. All right. Unless I roll crazy.
So it comes to this.
Nope. 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 Would have loved to have gotten a couple crits there.
Endure this.
Oh, you fell down. Fucking maul his ass. The grease came into play. Oh, Sila was gonna die this turn. Nope, couldn't overcome SR. Jeez. Come on, Sila.
You made your choice.
Yeah, I got it. I'll whack the shit out of him while he's down. Actually makes it harder for him, but I don't care.
Make every strike count. He'd better start running.
Nice.
Pleasantries.
Ooh, nice ring. Ring of chaotic fascination. Agile dagger. Lucky dice. Randomly grant the owner plus one luck bonus on attack or damage rolls or AC during the enemy's attack once per day. This effect lasts for the whole day. Alright. Just loot the whole damn thing. Plus two in Ring of Protection. Additionally, it increases the DC for all saving throws and spells against the Enchantment School by two. Also, yeah, okay. Interesting. I don't have an Enchanter. Wow. Yay for surviving.
Anything new?
Thanks, Lan. You're so awesome, Lan.
Okay, well, I'm going to save this. That wasn't exactly fun. I mean, it was fun, but man, the amount of buffs I had to use just to even get that guy to go down.
Watch out for trouble.
Thank you.
land. You're so awesome, land.
Headband of mental flow. Int and charisma. Okay.
Keep your calm.
There's just so much I could loot here. It'd be all weight. I mean, if I really feel like I need the coin. Good, I do have the Sword of Valor. Did I do it wrong? I guess I did. Wand of Good Hope. Wow. Could have probably used that. Oh well. Probably should have sold junk to Wilser. But apparently handing the banner to Queen Golfrey isn't the answer. Thank you. This place is just utterly nasty. Game auto-saved.
Smile. The world's not ending just yet.
Save myself. The legendary banner of the Crusaders is right in front of you. A drop of blood falls from it. From where? The wound in your chest must have reopened and now it's bleeding again. Ugh. You touch Almaday's holy banner to brush away the scarlet droplet when you freeze abruptly. All of a sudden, you are aware of your own powers. You are no longer a grain of sand resisting the countless armies of the Abyss. You are something greater. Like Almaday, you once rejected your humanity to ascend and gain divinity. Are you ready to take the first step on the path to gaining power? But what will your power look like? Aha. Epitome of rage. I already have a halo. Spirit Paladin. Or be blinded. Wow, blinding light's pretty awesome. It is a fortitude save, though, not a great one. No, but I was pretty certain I was gonna go a. Oh, that's interesting. Benefits the allies and hinder enemies. Once activated, lasts the combat. Alright, enemies try to make a will save to resist the effect, receive -2 if they have chaotic alignment. Okay. Aeon Bane. Any weapon you wield count as having Bane. Wow. Your spells gain bonus equal to mythic rank to cast level checks to overcome SR. And every hit you make weapons or spells that... Wow. Whoa. Every hit you make weapons or spells, the spell effects on the target as per the dispel magic spell. Wow. Man, I was just thinking the other day, I was like, man, how cool would it be if my strikes could dispel shit? And here it literally is. Yeah, let's go Aeon. Okay, I wasn't really anticipating having to do this now, but... You don't automatically miss when you roll one on attack. Wow. Cleaving shot. Domain zealot. Okay. Greater abundant casting. I do like Unrelenting Assault here. If only because, like, I don't necessarily need abundant casting, like, greater abundant casting just yet. I can absolutely take this here and get more damage to my strikes. Thundering blows would be awesome. Slow vulnerability. During spells. Now that's an idea. To make my buffs really last. Effects of your spells here on your allies shall last longer than an hour, but shorter than 24 hours, now lasts 24 hours. Okay. Lasts longer than 5 minutes, but shorter than now lasts 24. Wow. Wow. I get a whole other domain if I want. Or use it as a swift action at least. So, it comes down to being able to do more damage with melee attacks, or prolong my buffs. It's honestly tough, but I don't think I'm going to go with this. Because I'll get stuff to prolong buffs before too long, but by the time I reach endgame, who cares? Forcing gaze. At third rank, the Aeon gains the ability to enforce rules on everything around them, giving various benefits to the allies and journey enemies. Once activated, this ability lasts until combat ends, at which point all the bonuses immediately disappear. Enemies try to make a will saving throw to resist this effect, receiving minus 2 on the throw if they have the chaotic alignment. Okay. Honestly, like that as a caster level boost. One plus two for two mythic ranks. Increased by one per three mythic ranks. Okay. I'm gonna go with that one. The Aeon has its own spell book. Immune to poison, disease, and confusion. The wound on your chest closes, then drops of blood spilled on the Sword of Valor bursts into transparent flames. A wave of fire rushes out from the blood and across the entire banner, just transforming it and emblazing it with new colors. Power descends upon you, suffusing your mortal body, remaking it to in its image. It fills your body up to the brim, breaking bones and tearing muscles while at the same time healing them. Wow. You raise your head, acutely aware that you've been blessed to mete out justice, maintaining the stability of the cosmic border from here to eternity.
Thought my life was hard with the crusaders we have now. Worse is yet to come.
What an interesting turn of events. Such intriguing power. Boy, if you should suddenly expire, I would be happy to dissect your remains.
Strange kind of power. Suspicious. I can't make head nor tail of it. Are you sure you'll be able to control it?
I don't know. Now's the time to act. Oh, wow. Absolutely, yeah, I'm going to restore balance.
Lady, this creature's about to die. Shouldn't you?
Behold, Ionami. Behold the death I saw.
You see, Suchu? Shouldn't has no place here. I've waited for a very long time, but now the hour has come to turn my ideas into reality. I still have things to do in Canopus, but you must leave. Go to the old laboratory. I have a special test for you.
The laboratory? I hate that foul place, but I dare not disobey you, my lady.
Forgive me this little masquerade.
I actually have her mini. I used her as an NPC from, well, not NPC, but as part of a PC, as a summoner. Those were fun times. Anyway. Relu Vorlesh.
I am a Relu Vorlesh, also known as the Architect of the World Wound.
Relu who? Wait. That's a realum?
Watch it. She's deadlier than a dozen demons. The betrayer of humanity. Her words are poison and lies.
Oh, Lady Arilu. I, Nenio, am your most devoted admirer. Your research is an invaluable contribution to the development of science on Galarion. And this experiment with a world wound is simply groundbreaking. May I please have your autograph?
One look from Aurelio and then you'll fall silent.
You've handled the power of the Sword of Valor well. Such artifacts are almost like living creatures, and they react to their own kind, shall we say. The Sword of Valor once belonged to a mere mortal who became a goddess. It seems to see something kindred in you. Touching you has left the sword irreversibly changed. Now it is your banner, not Iomide's. Although perhaps it will still stop the demons from teleporting to the city as before.
You've helped me twice already. We found them the case in here, pointed away to the Sword of Valor.
I'm creating something. Building. Studying how the land lies. Laying the foundation. I am called the Architect for a reason. I'm not asking you to trust me. That would be unforgivably stupid. But I suggest, just suggest, that you search, analyze, think. What happened in old Sarkoris? What is the world wound? What is happening to you? Search for your answers. And for now, farewell.
Yet another obstacle.
Yeah. Cool new banner. I'm a little surprised by it, but okay.
You've crossed the wrong mongrel.
They don't know how frightful they are.
Critical hit with a blinding ray.
The light take you.
Out of my sight.
Just
have to resort to brute force. Yikes, what a
crit. You won't survive me.
Oh, they got mythic as well. Up to him.
Do not fear. Do not waver.
Yes.
What the hell's going on?
You're irrelevant.
So it comes to this.
This will be the stuff of legend. Clawing time.
Make every strike count.
I will see to your demise.
The inheritor, guide my blade.
Hey. Citadel's main floor? Okay, this is something else entirely. Alright. I'm realizing this is kind of getting a little long here, so what I'm going to do is save and break episode for it now. So, thank you so much for watching. I'm going to take care of all the mythic abilities in the meantime, and I'll see you in the next episode.